Let's look now into Laplace transform and filtering. So Laplace transform and filtering. So remember our analog filter. So we've got an x of t, an input signal, and we've got an output signal. And we've got our impulse response h of t here. So now we know that the Laplace transform is quite convenient here, because if we have our input signal x of t, this is convolved by h of t, and then this gives us our y of t. Yeah, so it's our convolution operation. So in the Laplace space here, we could write then just x of s multiplied by h of s gives us y of s. That's the multiplication operation. So this is here the Laplace transform of our filter. So the question is now, here, so what kind of properties, so what can we get out of this h of s here? Properties of h of s, so are we getting some useful information out of this h of s about our filter? Okay, so let's have a look a bit closer towards this. So remember, in the time domain, so if we just stick first with the time domain, just to have it here, so in the time domain, our h of t, this was our impulse response. Our impulse response. So now if we go into the Laplace domain, then we've got our h of s here. So what can we do with this h of s here? So remember, let's just write down the Laplace transform again here. So that's h of s integral from 0 to infinity e to minus st dt. So remember, if we are substituting now just in j omega here, then we are getting the e to minus, oops, there's the h of t missing here, e to minus j omega t dt here. And so this looks like a Fourier transform, and because we have causal signals, this is actually a Fourier transform here in this case. So in other words, if we're putting the j omega in there, we should be getting a spectrum out there, or a frequency distribution. So two, so we've got this h of s, so this is our Laplace transform. Transform of our impulse response. Of our impulse response h of t, let's write this here. So then with our definition of the Laplace transform, if you're putting a h to j omega there, then this gives us a frequency response. So usually what we would like to plot is the absolute value or the ups in MATLAB. Yeah, so something like this, just to get the amplitude. Amplitude response. So this is essentially the amplitude response of our filter. Yeah, so for example, if this is here omega, this is h to j omega, and we're getting a response which looks like that, then this is obviously a low pass. So the amplitude response gave us was calculated in this way here. So this was the amplitude response. So now another thing what we can do with this h of omega here. So the h of j omega is a complex number. So the whole expression here is a complex number. Yeah, so this gives us an angle here of the real and the imaginary part. And this angle defines a phase shift. Yeah, so this angle here, so if you write arc of h of j omega, this defines the phase shift at the frequency omega. So with this we're getting our phase shift, so we could call this phi or so.